Hi, I'm Sana Ing, and this is what is in my pencil case. And my pencil case is from Derwent. And this has two compartments, and I will go first through this smaller compartment. I have binder clip. And the reason why I always keep binder clip is with me is because when I use my sketchbook, sometimes the pages start to like... Well, the sketchbook aren't laying flat, so I clip a little binder clip on the side so it will keep pages nice and flat. I have sharpener, just standard Muppet sharpener. Nothing fancy, I just wanted a small sharpener that has a compartment. And this is kneadable eraser that I use sometimes when sketching, especially if I want to like erase my sketch and ink the lines afterwards, I use this. It has been working really great for me, and I love these Faber-Castell ones because they come this small case, because these really get every piece of dust and hair in them. Blending stamp. I really like to use blending stamp when doing like graphite work or even colored pencil works, so I keep it one in my pencil case. And this is Tomboy Mono Zero eraser, round tip. And I really like this when erasing small details. Washi tape. I use this to stick a lot of things in my sketchbook and sometimes repairing my sketchbook if it's falling apart. And eraser. This eraser actually from Faber-Castell, and I really love these black erasers. I have quite many of these. And next to the main compartment. First I have my two favorite fountain pens. Twisby 580. This has extra fine nib. It's the standard one. And the ink I'm using in this one is Sailor Kiwakuro. And this is piston filler, so all the ink is here. And I keep this in my pencil case, even if it's fountain pen. It has some ding and scratches, but I don't care, they are tools. Especially these modern ones that are easy to replaceable, but I'm not taking like different pencil case for my fountain pens with me every time. And this is Twisby Eco in lime green. I really love this color. And it has custom needlepoint nib. I will leave the link down below in the description where I got the nib. And this too is one of my favorite fountain pens. Then Sakura Gel Roll white gel pen I use for highlights. And this is the only one I can get here, so I don't have choices. It's great when it works, but it's clogged so easily that it's often not so great. Here I have my fine liners that I take with me. I usually ink with fountain pens, but sometimes I want consistent line weight, so I use my fine liners. And I use Rotrin Digigraphit. These have pigment-based ink. Nibs are really durable. I have used this so much, and still nibs are like completely intact. They really work well. I have been using Microns Neo because Copic ones, like every fine liner there is, and these are the only ones that I like because these nibs are really durable. They really stand drawing, and they are not like leaking. They start to like breaking up, and I often use them till they run out of ink and till the nib may be fine. So that's great for those. Then I have standard Staedtler highlighter. I recently got this, and I love green and green highlighter inks, so I have green highlighter in my pencil case. Other thing that I quite love is colored LEDs. I have green pilot color now. It has green LED that is erasable. This has red LED from Uni. I think it's Uni Nano Color Dia something. And this has blue. I really like sketch black in blue and red, and with green, of course, because green is my favorite color. I really prefer using Prismacolor color erasers, but I'm really afraid that I will break them in my pencil case, so I will use those instead. Then one of my favorite brush pen. This is Pentel watercolor brush in gray, and I really like how this works. It has nice juicy brush, and it makes beautiful grays, and it's actually really great for monochromatic sketches and shading. Then I have two white Poshkas. I use this for highlights. I have this huge tipped one, which I use for larger highlights, and then the smaller one has like fine tip. And I really like both of these ones. They work much better than the gel pens. Then I have more gel pens here. I have again Sakura Kelly Rolls in silver and gold. I like to use this as accent my drawings, like drawing jewelry or piercings or something metallic. I use these two. And then I have my brush pen there. And I have a Pentel brush pen, but I don't like that because it has no converter. I have to like buy those refills, and I find brush a little bit clunky, so I use Kuretake one. And this has real sable hair brush end. And this use platinum converters. No converters are actually almost empty. This use converter, so I can just take this cartridge, this converter out and fill it with bottle ink, so I generate no waste by using disposable cartridges, and this works well. Also, I can bought like replacement brushes for this, so I don't need like buy a new pen. And this is metal pocket. This feels much greater in the hand than the Pentel Pocket brush pen. So this is what I like and use. Then, because I often do watercolors, I have my travel brush here, which is this one. This is Da Vinci Maestro Voyage 110, and the neat feature is it's really easy to put back because there are no way you can damage the bristles because there's this metallic sleeve that goes over it. And also this feels really great in hand because it's all the way same parallel, and there's nice hold this. I really like this is size 6 because I find it's versatile enough for my sketchbook. And then there is a Lonely Carandas Luminance in white. I don't have a Carandas Luminance pencil, so I decided to try one, and I really love this white, especially in colored sketchbook. This works beautiful. These are wax base, really opaque and really great, also really expensive. That's why I have only one. And then my graphite supplies. This is my favorite graphite pencil, and this is running out. I think I'm not going to find this anywhere because this is discontinued now, and the newer model is much thinner. As you can see, this has thick lead, much thicker than the normal pencils. It's Conto Paris graphite in age. I really like to draw in with hard leads because they leave so faint marks and they are easily to erasable. This is my clutch pen. It has also hard lead. And this is Carandas fixed pencil. I really wanted to get like clutch pencil at one point, and then suddenly I found this pencil lying on the bus stop in the middle of winter. And of course I grabbed this. This has some dings and scratches because I think people are getting it around, but I really like this. And I have been drawing this. There's like sharpener on the back. It has metal body. It is a great clutch mechanism, it takes 2mm leads. And then I have my new favorite, Palomino Blackwing. These pens are really awesome. This has firm graphite, and this is actually really dark. And this one pencil can make like all faint marks to the dark marks, and it works beautiful. Also, the eraser is really great. And this came in 12 package, and I have still going through my first one, but as you can see, it is quite short now, so I may soon need to replace this. So that is what my pencil case. And usually I just try to keep my pencil case like minimum, but there still happen to be quite much of stuff. So leave a comment below what is in your pencil case. And if you have made a pencil case video, please link it to me. I really love to watch what is other people's pencil cases, because I think the things that artists keep their pencil case are actually their favorite supplies, so you can see like really what they like. So thanks for watching, and hope I see you in my next video. Bye!